हेलो एस हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ आर एस सोनावणे, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ असंजय विज लेट सौ कांताबाई भोरलाल जी जैन कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग चांदवड. इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ ई लर्निंग. फ्रॉम टुडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ इंट्रोडक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ आवर सब्जेक्ट. द सब्जेक्ट नेम इज इन्वायरमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग. So, in today's lecture, we will see a subject details, Bloom taxonomy, course objective, syllabus of environmental engineering 2, course outcomes. So, subject details, what university frame the syllabus? So, you can see here, the subject core is 401001, the subject name as per university, that is environmental engineering 2. These are the teaching scheme. It's for required only teachers, and this is the exam scheme. There will be the 30 marks of in some exam, 50 marks for the oral exam, 70 marks for the in some exam. The total weightage of this subject is 150 marks. These are the subject details. So when we learn anything, any subject in engineering, we require some stages. Your knowledge should be implemented base, is it? So when we learn any subject, any concept, we required these six step. The first step will be remember, second understand, third one apply, fourth one analyze, fifth one evaluate, and last one is a create. So in this subject, we will learn a six unit, and during this semester you have to give one exam in it, may be in sem or end sem. Suppose that we learn a definitions of a sewage, and a same definition will ask in the exam, and you have to write a same definition as it is. It will be remember based knowledge. Is that clear? It will be the remember based knowledge. The second thing, suppose that we have to learn some concept or some terms, and it will ask in an exam, you will write it in your own language. What you own language, it will be the understanding base. Remember, as it is, you have written there, and understanding is what you write as per your knowledge, what you understood that concept. Or such a type of understanding question will ask in the exam or exam question paper, that is classify, describe, discuss, explain, identify, locate, recognize, report, select, and translate. Same step number three, that is apply. So use the information in new situation. You have to use information in a new situation. That means execute, implement, solve, use, demonstrate, interpret, operate, schedule, and sketch. So solve, there are the maximum numerical example we always solve. So in exam, we are always ask the solve the numerical example. It is a part or apply your knowledge, what you learn, which is based on remember and understanding. Is that clear? The step number four, which is a Bloom level, that is a dog connection among the ideas. What we learn, what you understood from any term, any concept, then on that basis you can connect among the ideas in terms of differentiate, organize, relate, compare, contrast, distinguish, examine, experiment, question, and the test. Same the step, last second last step, that is evaluate. Just justify stand or a decision. Is that clear? It's related to or in terms of apprise, argue, defend, judge, select, support, value, critique, and weigh. Is that clear? This sixth and last one is related to the project work. You doing a something new. Is that clear? You do something new. So this evaluate and create is related to your project work. It's related to research work. This is a Bloom taxonomy, which is always required for the NBA work. For any institute, as well as when we learn, your knowledge should be go through this 6 step, that is cognitive domains. Okay, so every subject having some objective. Here is you can see here. So this course is nothing but as a subject, and every subject having some objectives. If we discuss about environmental engineering two subject, there will some objective I framed here. So to identify sewage, its characteristic source of a sewage. So first if we'll discuss about what you mean by sewage, or what you mean by sewage exactly. Sewage is the industrial waste or a domestic waste water that is in a liquid form, water or in a liquid form sewage, liquid form waste, that is called as a sewage. So first objective of this course or a subject is to identify sewage characteristic and the source of a sewage. The second objective, that is illustrate sewage treatment plant with its unit. So before dispose any sewage into the direct stream, it may be very hazardous to human being or agricultural purpose, so that each and every sewage should be treated. So we require sewage treatment. So in that we will identify what a sewage treatment plant, what are their different unit, that is second objective. Third objective is to illustrate and analyze secondary treatment treatment unit. Actually, in a sewage treatment unit, there are three main units: primary, secondary, and tertiary. So we illustrate in objective three, that is a secondary treatment units. It may related to activity sludge process and trucking filters. The fourth objectives of our subject is to know the principal working process, on-site sanitation, and the package sewage treatment plant. Sometime our sewage is disposed through direct on-site sanitation. So water should be processed, what are the principal, we will know through this objective in environmental engineering too. And last one objective of this subject is to know the advantages and disadvantages of oxidation pond, aerated lagoon, theory of root zone cleaning system. So these three terms, oxidation, aerated lagoons, and root zone cleaning, it's a part of on-site sanitation wastewater treatment. Okay, these are the objective of our course. So we will discuss in details of previous lecture of syllabus. So in this syllabus, we can see here unit number first will ask in details as per mentioned in our drill syllabus, sewage quantity, characters of sewage, and stream sanitations. This unit number four, which is divided into three part: sewage treatment, sewage quantity, characteristic of sewage, stream sanitation. In the first part, we will see collection and conveyance of a sewage, source of sewage, variation in a sewage flow, flow quantity estimation, design of circular sanitary sewer, pumping sewage, necessity, location of sewage, etc. Secondary part, it will be related to the sewage characteristic. Mostly in any sewage having a three characteristic, that is physical, chemical, biological characteristics. And as per CPCB norms, that is Central Pollution Central Board, there are some norms we will see in part, characteristics of sewage. And last one part in unit number first, that is stream sanitation. In stream sanitation, self purification of natural stream, river classification as per Maharashtra of river classification. Okay, unit number second, we will See a sewage treatment. What are the exact process of sewage treatment? Introduction of sewage treatment, preliminary, primary, secondary, and tertiary treatment process. These are three, fourth main unit in a sewage treatment plant: theory, design, and screening gate chamber. It's a component part of a sewage treatment plant, which we'll see in unit number second. In unit number third, we will see a design and theory of secondary treatment units. So in detail, introduction of unit, operation, process, secondary treatment, principal treatment, important microorganism, what are the micro and kinetic biological growth, cell growth, substrate limited growth, cell growth, and it will be detailed. It's a most important one in number three, that is the activity sludge process and trickling filter. That is a very important two terms in unit number second. Most of them ask for the 6 or 8 marks. Unit number four, low cost treatment method. That is oxidation pond and aerated lagoon. These are the two main part. What are the oxidation pond? How to bacteria algae symbiosis process? Then aerated lagoon is principal aeration method, and there are the advantages in unit number four. In unit number five, on-site sanitation, introduction of facetious treatment plant and anaerobic digester. We will see in details what are the on-site sanitation, it process or digestion process. Exactly, that is unit number five. So unit number six, there will be the totally different industrial wastewater treatment. What are the treatment used in industrial waste? That will be a method of sampling, equalization, neutralization, application, preliminary. Source of wastewater generation from the manufacturing process. These overall things we will see in unit number six. So as per our syllabus, by mention in university, SPPM, there are some term works. The term work first, that is compulsory assignment. In compulsory assignment, there are two things: brief report on sewer material, choice of material, testing of sewer pipe, sewer appendices. And second thing, that is the design of septic tank. It is a term work A part, and B part is experiment. So you can see here some experiment. The term work shall consist of journals giving details of at least 8 out of 12. That means here mention is a 12 assignment, a 12 experiment. Out of that, we have performed minimum 8 experiment. Following experiment conducted in environmental engineering 2 laboratory, which is serial number 12, it's a compulsory. Okay, we'll see in a serial number next slide. First, there are the 10 practical. 11 practical and serial number 12 is a compulsory. So we will perform near about 8 experiment included of serial number 12. So in that practical, there will be the solid, total solid waste, suspended solid, volatile solids, suitable solids. It's related to the TDS. That means how many types of solid presence in wastewater. Then a sludge volume index. We can find a sludge volume index of a wastewater. In the dissolved oxygen, what are the we can measure the oxygen or dissolved oxygen in a wastewater. Then BOD, COD, biochemical oxygen demand, chemical oxygen demand, electrical conductivity of a wastewater, then determination of phosphate by spectrophotometer, determination of nitrates. This is one of the content which is mostly present in the wastewater, which can be determined through the spectrophotometer. In experiment number 8, determination of heavy metal, like you can see chromium, zinc, nitrogen, this one. Determination of total nitrogen by Kaizen method. And 11th number, that is visit to domestic or industrial wastewater treatment plant, its detailed report. Okay, this is a 12th number assignment or serial number 12. That is a very, it's a mandatory. Said by the university to some mandatory. Okay, plant of ETP, sugar or denature, using a suitable software. Plant of ETP of a sugar or a dairy industry using a suitable software, which is made in a C programming of any other suitable software. Note that the term work should be included detailed analysis of practical interpretation significance and the application of test result. Here are some books and some reference book which we can be refer for this semester of environmental engineering 2 subjects. So textbook, you can see here, then out of that reference book, and archive those which is already available in our library. You can use that reference book as well as IS code. You can refer for this subject to designing a unit of a wastewater treatment plant, that is 3025 all parts. Resource e-resources, that is NPTEL and the cpcb.nic.in. So here are some course outcomes. Already we seen a course objective, what we learn in this subject. The course outcomes is nothing but after learning what we can do on the basis of our knowledge. So on the basis of knowledge of environmental engineering 2, when we learn a 6 unit, and on that 6 unit basis we can put our outcomes related to that subject. Here is the first: illustrate sewage quantity, characteristic of sewage, stream sanitation, and the design of circular sanitary sewers. That means students are able to illustrate sewage quantity, its characteristics, and design of circular sanitary sewer. That means student वो पढ़ के ये कर सकते हैं, सीवेज क्वांटिटी मेजर कर सकते हैं, उनका कैरेक्टरिस्टिक क्या है उनको वो जान सकते हैं, और वो डिजाइन ऑफ सर्कुलर सैनिटरी टैंक डिजाइन कर सकते हैं. देन एलोबरेट एंड एनालाइज सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट, प्रिलिमिनरी, प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शियरी. देन स्टूडेंट आर एबल टू एलोबरेट एनालाइज, दिस इज सेकेंड कोर्स आउटकम. The student are able to illustrate and analyze secondary treatment units, activated sludge process, beneficial filter. Then again, fourth one outcomes, that the student are able to explain the advantage and disadvantage of oxidation pond, related lagoons, theory of root zone, cleaning system. Then next one is student are able to illustrate the on-site sanitation package, sewage treatment plant. And the last one is student are able to apply the method of sampling, equalization, and neutralization related to the industrial waste. These are the course outcome. This course outcome may student are able to do these 6 things, but when you learn that 6 unit of environmental engineering 2, then it can be able to the outcomes are noted here. Okay, so thank you very much.